And I'm here to talk to you about English language. Who did you have previous?
Literature.
Fab, okay, so you already know that we've decided to split it up. As I'm sure you're aware, at the end of last year we decided to change the exam board for English language. And part of what I'd like to explain to you this evening is a little bit more detail about why we decided to do that and why we did it when we did. When we chose the exam board WJC at the start of last year, well, we chose it earlier than that, we had done a lot of research about it, and with the materials that we could gather at that point, it seemed like the best option of a set of extremely hard GCSE exams. As the year went on, we actually discovered that the exam board didn't really give us very much material to work with, so we were struggling to know what to expect. And with the small amount of materials that we did receive, the papers and the questions, they weren't predictable. So in the older GCSEs that we've been teaching up until now, you always knew, for example, that question one was about summarising, that question two was about language analysis, so and so on and so forth. So it was very predictable, and every student knew exactly what they were being tested on at which point. That wasn't the case with the WJC, and as we got further through the year, we just decided that it wasn't giving the students the best opportunity to show what we knew they knew. They tried so hard, and it just wasn't allowing them to gain marks in the right way. So although it was a bit of a scary decision to make that change, we do honestly think we've done even more research now. We've liaised with lots of different other schools and spoken to the new exam board, AQA, and we really do think it's going to give people the best option and a real clear idea of exactly what each paper is expecting and what each question is asking you for and how best to demonstrate that. So we think it's fab because the question stems, kind of the wording of the questions, remain the same from paper to paper. So we're back to that model of saying question one, paper one, will always be asking you to lift a statement from the example, things like that, which is absolutely great because kids know exactly what exam they're going into, what skill they're trying to show off, and can do their very best. The second fab thing about it is that with the writing sections, there are fewer questions. So with the transactional and persuasive writing, on the old last year's paper, they were expected to write two very different pieces of writing to a high standard within an hour. So they only had half an hour to plan and produce and check one piece and then replicate. But both of those pieces had to demonstrate very different skills. And it was just so hard. Even people that would consider themselves to be highly proficient writers, when we tried to do it, it's just so difficult to show off everything that you needed to show off. So that's gone. There is just one question that you have to answer in order to show off that persuasive writing skill. On the creative writing side, you still get a choice of question, but one of those questions actually comes with a picture as a stimulus. So if the theme is something that they're not particularly familiar with, or actually even if they just have a bit of a meltdown on the day and they've lost the plot a little bit, which absolutely is understandable, they've got something to pin their thoughts on, they've got that picture as a starting point to kind of ground them and calm them down and think, okay, that's what I'm writing about, I know I've got to show off these skills and then they can match those two together. So the practicalities of the new exam are absolutely in our favour, and we truly believe it's going to allow us to allow the students to show off their best ability. And I do think that, you know, the year 10 exams, that was the kind of final nail in the coffin for the WJC for us, because we did just think it didn't allow them to show how brilliant they really are and how hard they've been working. That was the most frustrating thing. We could tell that they've been trying and it just didn't allow them to show that. So in order to support that, we have given absolutely everybody a booklet that looks like this. If you haven't seen a physical copy of it, ask for it. It does exist, I promise you. It will also be on their Igoe page because teachers have posted it as homework, so it should come up in the assignment section, which is the part that you can access. If you haven't got that, please ask your child to come and get another one from me or drop me an email and I will send you the PDF of it, whatever is easiest for you. So the idea of this is it goes through the exams as such. So we've got paper one, a reading section and a writing section, paper two, a reading section and a writing section. And the booklet goes through it in that direction. For each part of the qualification then, we have gone through the procedure of giving the students an example question, then several example answers, and a mark scheme. So the first thing they are asked to do is to read the question and any material related to it, read different answers that we have written or the exam board have written, and then then to apply the mark scheme and say what mark they would give it. So first of all, that makes them engage with the mark scheme and understand what the examiners are actually wanting for them. If you're only giving them 3 out of 10, what's missing? So the second part of that is actually we ask them to explain why they've given it that mark. If it scores full marks, fab. Why does it get those full marks? What skills has it demonstrated? How is it perfect? And the flip side of that is we've deliberately included some bad answers as well, so that they can say, okay, it does this, so I can give it 3 out of 10, but it doesn't do X, Y, Z, therefore it can't get more than a 3. So they get practice at articulating what is there and what is good, but also what is missing. As I say, that makes them engage with what the examiners are wanting, but also what we're hoping is then when they complete the next step, which is a similar question that they then have to respond to themselves, they've got that understanding, and they can then look at their own work and think, actually, yes, I've demonstrated all of these skills, I know I've located the correct information, I'm confident that answer is a good, solid answer, and it starts to become more accurate at predicting their own performance. So each section of this follows that pattern, that they get given a sample with sample answers and a mark scheme, they engage in it that way, they then have to do it themselves and demonstrate what they've understood in the prior bit. This is homework at the moment, but it can be marked either in class as a whole group, or teachers might choose to mark it themselves, that's teacher preference to some extent, but it will be marked and students will be able to see how they're doing. Having said that, I don't mind if they're getting it all wrong. I would rather that they're showing us in this booklet that they're not understanding it, because then we can actually zone in on what they're finding difficult and go through it in more detail, or get them to come back after school or something and just kind of really underline what it is that they are missing. So if they do that, they should end up with a whole completed booklet of how to be brilliant at this qualification for English language, which we then hope, because they're completing it now at the beginning of the year, that later on when their revision really begins in earnest, they can then come back to this and either look at it and think, yeah, actually, I've got a really solid understanding, I agree with myself, I've got all of that right, or look back at it and think, oh, actually, if I look at that answer now, I would give it a 7, I wouldn't give it a 5, because they can kind of show themselves what they've learnt and improved on. So where are you coming, hopefully? Is kind of helping them complete this booklet. Now, that doesn't necessarily mean sitting down and completing every single word with them, but asking them to perhaps to explain to you why a particular question gets it. The mark schemes are relatively brief, so it wouldn't take you long to look at it and kind of recognise what's being asked for, and just kind of having that conversation and that justification with them is really, really going to help push them forward. The other skill that would be really, really the other thing that would be really brilliant for you to practice with them would be locating information in a specific area. Some of the questions are worded very particularly and say, for example, what did you learn about bikes in the 1800s in lines 7 to 22? If they wrote a fact that was found in line 65, it might be about bikes in the 1800s, but they won't get credited for it because it's not in the correct area. So actually them being very aware that they have to read the questions carefully and to pick out those key areas. Some people like highlighting, that's great, and you can kind of set different areas up with colours so you know where you're looking for it. But having that skill to really isolate particular information so that they can gain. There are some small marked questions where all they are asked to do is lift a piece of information from a particular part and they get credit for it. They don't even have to reword it. Sometimes it can be literally copying. But if they don't copy it from the right place, they lose that opportunity. And those are kind of slightly smaller, I don't really want to say easier marks, but they are easier to obtain. And it would be great if they all are guaranteed those marks because they are absolutely accurate at practicing that drawing of information for particular places. That's all I wanted to say. So, like I say, if you haven't seen this booklet or if you don't know it exists, it is their homework for this half term, so please do encourage them to be completing it. If you notice that they struggle with a particular element of it, please do let us know, either myself or their class teacher, because then we'll zoom in even more on that particular area, whether that's in class or outside of as an extra provision. So I think classroom teachers, you've probably already got their emails, but I'm Sophie Igoe, which is SIGOE @chesterton.com. So